But let's include Dan's belief system, which is in a sense a kind of metaphysically grounded Darwinism. Let's also show the influence of that Darwinism in shaping social Darwinism, sterilization. Let's show the influence of Darwinism in the Nazi movement in Germany. Let's assign Richard Weikart's book From Darwin to Hitler, which shows, for example, that the Nazis were inspired really by two main currents. Social Darwinism on the one side and Nietzschean atheism on the other. The combination of the will to power and survival of the fittest were essentially recruiting slogans for the Nazis. I would moreover say that instead of crying crocodile tears about the Inquisition, which occurred 500 years ago, and in which over the space of 350 years, some 2,000 people were killed, which apparently keeps Dan awake at night, let's focus a little bit more on the crimes of atheism, which didn't occur in ancient times. Let's not just focus on the Salem witch trials. We can pick up the tourist guide and realize that despite Arthur Miller's play, the number of people killed in the Salem witch trials was precisely 18. Now that is 18 too many, I'll grant you, but it doesn't even compare to what atheist regimes have done, again, not in ancient times, but in our own lifetime, in the last century. I'm not just talking about Mao in China or Stalin in Russia, I'm also talking about Pol Pot. Here's a guy in the space of 3 years who killed 2 million people. What about Ceausescu, Enver Hoxha, Fidel Castro, Kim Jong-il, atheist murders in the name of atheism are still going on. Now Richard Dawkins in his book The God Delusion says, oh yes, but the religious crimes were in the name of religion, but the crimes of atheism were not in the name of atheism. This is kind of what happens when you let a biologist out of the lab. Because here is a guy who has apparently a zero comprehension of history. All you have to do is open up the Communist Manifesto. All you have to do is look at the atheist regimes, which said very explicitly, we want to create a new man and a new utopia freed from the shackles of traditional religion and traditional morality. So even bin Laden in his wildest dreams could not begin to rival the body count of atheist regimes, which begins not in the thousands or the tens of thousands, but in the millions and the tens of millions. An ocean of blood and a mountain of bodies produced by atheism in recent history. Now, so I think we should include all that in the course. I think it would be a valuable factual addition to what our children should learn. What kind of society do we want to be part of? Is there a reason to believe in a transcendent basis for the world? How did it come to be? For us, why are we here? At the end of the day, this is a matter of what Pascal called the wager. And by the wager, what he meant was you can bet on God. And he said, if you're wrong, what's going to happen? Well, you've made a metaphysical mistake. On the other hand, you can bet against God. And if you're wrong, alas, you will be separated from God. Not by his choice, by the way, by yours. You are cutting yourself off from God. And Pascal's point is, why would any rational person choose against God? If you choose against him, you lose nothing. If you choose for him, you have the prospect of gaining everything. And so the idea here is to humbly open yourself up to God. Of course, do it on the basis of evidence, not against the evidence. But the idea is that if you do, ultimately, you might come to see that God is a human creation, but we humans are a divine creation, are the product not only of divine intelligence, but to some degree also of divine love. Thank you very much.
Let's see, all of these different points. Well, let's go back to your opening numbers of atheist murders. Yes, the number of people killed by atheists in the 20th century is terrible. Let's see, all of these different points. Well, let's go back to your opening numbers of atheist murders. Yes, the number of people killed by atheists in the 20th century is terrible. Let's see, all of these different points. Well, let's go back to your opening numbers of atheist murders. Yes, the number of people killed by atheists in the 20th century is terrible.